song shall dwell among them. They shall hunger no more, neither thirst any more. Neither shall the sun light on them, nor any heat. For the Lamb which is in the midst of the throne shall feed them, and shall lead them unto the fountains of waters. And God shall wipe away all the tears from their eyes. This is the word of the Lord.
My uncle, the same parents with my mother. He's done a lot for me because he made me what I am today. He's a great man. He's a family man. He loves his children. He doesn't play with them. We love him and he loved us. He helped his family. I can remember how many of us he helped. Some are politicians now, big guys. So we thank God for everything. The family will continue to remember him. The whole town is from Obiaroko. We also remember him.
I'll miss his words of wisdom. as when you're a child, when your father tells you not to do certain things, you never understand till you get to a mature age. And then you start understanding the things your father told you, starts making sense. And so I'll miss those words of wisdom that he gave.
My prayer for the children and the whole family would be that God will grant them the fortitude to bear the loss, but also the ability to move on and to know that their father and grandfather is now in a better place. We loved him, but God loved him more.
have taken into my gaze, that at the singing of my tongue, I will really keep my mouth within breathing, while in the air is before me. My mouth was not within me, while I was sitting in front of me. Then spake I with my heart. The Lord God made my days as a man breath, and my age is as nothing for me. Verily, every man at his best state is altogether vanity.
This is the word of God.
Let us thank God for the land, for the time that He spent with us. Let us talk to God that the Almighty God will comfort the family and well wishes that He has left behind. Let's turn to item 7 on page 8. Almighty God, who had bound together your elect in one communion and fellowship with the body of your Son Jesus Christ, grant, we pray, to the whole church in paradise and on earth your light and your peace. Amen. Grant that those who have been cleansed by the death and resurrection of Christ may die to sin and rise to the newness of life, and through your grace we may pass through the gate of death to your joyful resurrection. Grant to us who are still on our pilgrimage and who walk as yet by faith that your Holy Spirit may lead us in holiness and righteousness all the days of our life. Grant to your people pardon and peace, that we may be cleansed from all our sins and serve you with a quiet mind. Grant to those who mourn, especially to the family of our brother Michael, the sure confidence in your fatherly care, that casting all their grief on you, they may know the consolation of your love. Help us, we pray, in the midst of this we cannot understand, to believe and trust in the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, and the resurrection of life everlasting.
Thank you.
the signal officers on the earth, and at this era, we did the service and sensitivities there, and all of you who are there, thank you very much. May you have protect the glorious gospel in the mighty name of Jesus. I met back in 1970, when I was in the in the first of his meeting, and just come from the government as the medical officer. And I met him when I was an engineer. And the Civil War was arriving to an end. He was a very active person. He had difficulty standing or sitting still in many ways. He was always on the move. But when it comes to work, it would be meaning and joking and being on there, but when I say that there's a problem somewhere, particularly when we have abolished in West Nigeria, it started to become a big change to this. Very serious. In love, believing. In love that community didn't begin when it was function of the beginning. And in love, it's a profession. It's an engineering profession. And on many details, it is. Never yet, it is what was an engineer. As a son, I decided yesterday. All is together, whatever you do, you shall be the best of your abilities. Mine was a very reserved person. In his presence, there was no problems. You crack the joke, and you make him laugh. But also, and he was very loud. Be in the place and motion from his mind is allowed. And even if I don't have a power of the Holy Ghost, and remember when I saw him annoyed, angry, you might get it, but that was the man I opposed. Not his wife died. Who would be able to put him down? Couldn't find any guy in the area. Went together and came down. And was very, very protective of her. That it is well known that the man is right for 24 years. Now, I don't see a mission as difficult. But then, God says, I cannot be you, I cannot do I pursue you. The Lord is stand by you. The Lord is kind to you. The Lord is support you. The Lord will lead you up, and you will never fall. You will never fall from. The old age will continue to grow in your life. And the children, all of them, were very happy to have them, and they were very, very interested in their work. Why the education was possible. I was a very functional person. Look at the pictures of the program, the program. You can see the way he was dressed. He was a fashion star. All these things. When you get yourself, you see how long they have to come back. I remember one when the house was on fire. The national day, it was not a good one. And the driver was standing on the side of the front. And then, at the point where Michael just rushed inside, he said, my God, he said, ah, thank God, this is the only house I have. It was God born. Went inside, this is the man of it. It was a air conditioner, and when put it back and stop the fire. And then you put it out fire and bring it to see. Very accident, very dangerous. It's not coming to be able to do it. But it seems like a spiritual system of higher values giving you. And you will get to the heart of things in that sense and trust them. The man has been happy to come and ask you to come to you. I'm struggling to give you what you say. But the power of God will protect me and allow me. And we're very grateful for you today. So whatever can be able to do, my deeds and the suffering of all of you to do in the midst. So you can see this and then you can see that it is extremely mixed sadness and fond memories that the devil can is elsewhere. To remember a life's life and to say, with the gift of life, we are reminded of the brevity of life. Life is short. My dear, he was content with what he had. He then looked at another person and he said, we are not a single one. I'm not a God. No. Was happy with what he had. And the scripture teaches us to remember that our days are few. As we met in Psalm 39 a few minutes ago, as it's not by surely all my very strength and the number of my days, let me know how pretty my life is. I have made my days in the air and breath. Found out that yes, this has been happening for the world. Everyone is on the grave, even those who seem secure. But those who place their faith in Jesus Christ, which are given to me, need not fear. Because of him, they have done that. So the first question for me is to come today. And when Jesus Christ talks of this in the Gospel of John, when he said, "Truly, truly, I tell you, whoever hears my word and believes in him who sent me has eternal life, and will not be judged, but have everlasting life." The monk also said, "I have the resurrection and the life. Whoever believes in me, though he die, yet shall he live. And everyone who lives and believes in me shall never die." Let me put this question: do you believe this? God of heaven, 5:26. Do you believe in the resurrection of the apostle? People of God, there are none who escaped death. Nobody. All people were unfortunately died. And in that instant, when you have the confusion face before God, because the Bible tells us that it is appointed for man to die what comes. And what comes after that? Judgment. The Lord made happy is in his and sent before me all the days of his life. And he died. Mike has saved the Lord. And he has given an account of those days he was given as we all was a great life. Are able to speak to us now. I think we want to share with us four important things four important truths. And I want to listen to you. Number one, mind you what you to do that salvation and not be kind. There is a privilege of this people. And we have to do proposition for the Lord to take care of. Therefore, says, for my grace, you have been saved. Through faith, and this is not for the world, it is in the gift of God. That's the result of God's. So that no man will go. Ephesians 2:7-9. Number two, my God will also want us to know that all people are saved and are therefore guilty before God. Paul says in Romans 6:23, all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. And the fourth thing I believe might be the one of you is that the penalty for our sin is death. But that we can escape that spiritual death by accepting God's free gift of salvation in Jesus Christ. Romans 6:23 says, the wages of sin is death, but the free gift of God is eternal life in Christ Jesus our Lord. Lastly, I believe you might, we want to know that in order to receive God's free gift of eternal life, we must place our faith and trust in Jesus Christ.
Thank you. this day and brother Michael. We thank you for giving him to us, his family and friends, to know and to love as a companion on our earthly pilgrimage. In your boundless compassion, console us, woman. Give us faith to see in earth the gate of eternal life, so that in quiet confidence we may continue our course on earth. But by your call, we are reunited with those who have gone before, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Lord Jesus Christ, we commend to you our brother, Michael, who was reborn by water and the Spirit of baptism. Grant that his death may be called to us your victory over death, and be an occasion to renew our trust in your Father's love. Give us, we pray, the faith to follow when you have led the way, and when we believe and pray with the Father and the Holy Spirit, now and forever. O Lord, be merciful to all around us, especially those who have traveled from far and near places to come to serenity with the bereaved, and grant them a safe return. Bless, guide, and defend them, protect them from all perils and dangers of the road. Prosper them in their cause, that they be holding your mercy and praising you for your goodness here. May them all be working with the desire for the full enjoyment of their privileges as fellow citizens, the saints in your heavenly household, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Please sit back.
The Lord be with you. In Christ's name, I want to welcome each and every one of us to this service of farewell to our beloved brother in Christ, Father Michael, a fellow professor. We thank God for his life and times. Thank God for the good testimonies that we have listened to about his life. At this time, I want to pray that the light of virtue will shine upon his dead soul, and that the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ will be rise in glory in Jesus' name. I want to welcome especially our Father in the Lord, the retired provost of this cathedral, the very Reverend Dr. Luca Mungu. Papa, thank you for that message of life. I pray that in retirement and your old age, you will be redeemed by the Lord Himself. You will not falter in Jesus' name. I also want to welcome Mama, Oluwa Omolu. You are welcome. God will give you your strength in old age. I welcome the officers and men of Nigerian Navy. Thank you for coming to farewell. I pray that on your own day, it will be a glorious departure in the mighty name of Jesus. I now want to offer our commiserations to the family, particularly the children, and actually, yes, it's not easy to part with loved one, but to have the Lord is mighty to save, who will never fail. He has promised that you will be father of your fathers, you will be my father. He has promised to be husband to you. Mama, this God will be your husband. I pray that the memory of your departure will continue to be blessed and be sweet in your hearts to the very end, in Jesus' name. I thank all those who have contributed to the success of this service in the way of Stuart, Cathedral Choir, sextons, leaders, God will reward for the law of love in the mighty name of Jesus.
David played and it pleased the Lord, but you don't really care for music, do ya? Well, it goes like this, the fourth and fifth, the minor fall and the major lift, the baffled king composing hallelujah.
Off and is cut down like a flower. He flees as it were a shadow and never continues in our state. In the midst of life, we are in death. Of whom may we seek a succor but of you, O Lord? Yet, O Lord, O God most high, O Lord most mighty, O holy and merciful Savior, deliver us not into the bitter pain of eternal death. You know, Lord, the secrets of our hearts. Close not your merciful ears to our prayer, but spare us. Lord, most holy, O God, most mighty, O holy and merciful Savior, you most worthy judge eternal, suffer us not at our last hour for any pain of death to fall on us.
Serving and retired, the Assistant Bishop of Lagos and other officiating clergies, distinguished invited guests, gentlemen of the press, ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of the Chief of Naval Staff, I stand to read the funeral oration in respect of late Commodore Mike Ifenu Okwesa. The late Commodore Mike Ifenu Okwesa was born on the 21st of November 1940 in Obiaruku, Ndokwa West local government area of Delta State. The senior officer obtained his West African School certificate at Government College Ugele in 1960 and proceeded to Technical School Ibadan, Oyo State, from 1961 to 1962. The late senior officer obtained the joined the Nigerian Navy as a cadet officer in September 1962 and obtained a Bachelor of Science degree in Mechanical Engineering in 1967 from the Purdue University, Fort Wayne, United States of America. The senior officer rose through the ranks to the rank of Commodore, where he voluntarily retired from active service. His courses attended. During his career in the Nigerian Navy, the late Commodore Okwesa attended several courses in these institutions: United States Coast Guard School in York, Virginia, the Administrative Staff College of Nigeria, ASCON, in 1977, the Command and Staff College, Kaduna, in 1983, and the Nigerian Institute of Policy and Strategic Studies, Kuru, Jos, in 1988. During his course of service to the nation, the late senior officer held several appointments, which include engineering officer in Naval Base Apapa in 1972. In 1973, he was Staff Officer Engineering Headquarters, Western Naval Command. He was the Fleet Technical Officer, Western Naval Command in 1976, and Director of Engineering at Naval Headquarters in 1983. He commanded the Fleet Support Group in 1988, and he was Director of Admin and Logistics at the Ministry of Defense in 1990. He was also the general manager of the Naval Dockyard in 1992. The professional bodies to which the late senior officer belonged include the Institute of Mechanical Engineers, United Kingdom, the Society of Naval Engineers, United States of America, the British and Nigerian Institute of Management, and the Council of Registered Engineers in the United Kingdom, as well as a similar council here in Nigeria, the Council of Registered Engineers of Nigeria. The late senior officer was decorated with a Forces Service Star, Distinguished Service Star, Service Order, and member of the National Institute. He distinguished himself as a patriotic naval officer and as an administrator. He was loyal, disciplined, articulate, humble, and a reliable officer. The late senior officer served the Nigerian Navy meritoriously for 30 years and voluntarily retired on 31st December 1992. As the saying goes, from dust we came, and to dust we shall all return. Late Commodore Mike Ifenu Okwesa, retired, as it shall be said of all mortals, bowed to Mother Earth on the 15th day of March 2021. His death is a great loss not only to his family, but to the Nigerian Navy in particular, and indeed to our nation, Nigeria, in general. To our late senior colleague, we say we love you dearly, but God loves you most. It is on this note, on behalf of the Chief of Naval Staff, officers, ratings, and civilian staff of the Nigerian Navy, I pray for the repose of your soul. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, as we gather together today to remember and commemorate his life, let us bid him farewell as we mourn the loss of a lively, dignified soul, a gallant and brave professional, a gentleman officer, as well as a caring family man. his legacies will live on forever. Adieu, Commodore Mai Ifenu Okwesa. It is our practice that the letter of condolence, as well as the graveside oration, is handed over to the next of kin, which happens to be Mr. Mai Okwesa. So on behalf of the Chief of Naval Staff, officers, ratings and civilian staff of the Nigerian Navy, I hand over the letter of condolence and the graveside oration to you, sir. May the Lord console you and the family.
I heard there was a secret chord that David played and it pleased the Lord, but you don't really care for music, do ya? Goes like this, the fourth, the fifth, the minor fall and the major lift. The baffled king composing hallelujah.
Until we meet again before his throne, all that the Father gives me shall come to me. And he that comes to me, I will no wise cast him. He that raised Jesus from dead will also give life to our mortal bodies, that the Spirit that dwells in us. Wherefore my heart is glad, and my spirit rejoices. My patience shall rest in hope. You shall show me the path of life. In your presence is the fullness of joy.
In faith and in the hope of resurrection to eternity through our Lord Jesus Christ, we commend the soul of our brother, Michael, to Almighty God and commit his body to the ground, ash to ash, ashes to ashes. And dust to dust. May the Lord bless him and keep him.
Amen.
May the Lord make his face shine upon him and give him peace.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
The Lord's Prayer. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. And forgive us our sins and sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into
temptation, but deliver us
from evil. Now and forever.
Amen.
Michael, our brother, go forth upon your journey from this world, O Christian soul, in the name of God the Father who created you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ who suffered for you.
Amen.
In the name of the Holy Spirit who strengthened you.
Amen.
And may your rest this day be in peace.
Amen.
And your dwelling in the paradise of the people of God.
Amen.
And so the God of peace, who brought again from the dead our Lord Jesus Christ, the great shepherd of the sheep, by the blood of the eternal covenant, equip you all with everything good, that you may do his will, working in you that which is pleasing in his sight. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you all now and forevermore.
Amen.
I heard there was a secret chord that David played and it pleased the Lord. You don't really care for music, do ya? Well, it goes like this, the fourth, the fifth, the minor fall and the major lift. The baffled king composing hallelujah.
And
She broke your throat.